Left the town behind. Soon it'll be far behind. I'm heading out on an overnight camp. Slight problem, the road is closed. Well, there's a bike all fully loaded. I've got my tent, my drone, a few essentials on the handlebars there on the front. I've got my tools in there, water, the pannier bags all full of camping equipment, food in the saddle bag. I just stopped to admire the view of the freshly harvested fields. I've got about 8 miles to cycle. I'm going to end up about 8 miles over in that direction, where I'm going to meet up with my friend Tony, who's cycling from his home. And then we're going to meet up at that point up on the RidgeWay, and then we're going to cycle along the RidgeWay and find somewhere to camp for tonight. Okay, well, I'm on the climb up now. With weight on the bike, it's not too bad. I thought I would be struggling somewhat, but the steeper part of the hill is yet to come. Still climbed a fair old way though, as you may be able to see. I'm not sure what you can see at the downs there, but Alfred Williams, a local author and poet, talks about it, and in his book he reckons there's literally hundreds of little springs which come out down there. So anyway, we're on the harder part of the hill now. Still going good though. What I can say is thank goodness for a low geared bike, because that's quite some climb I'm coming up. So, but it's a breeze with the low gears. Well, that's the local high point around here, Charbury Hill. And the climb is over. There, 100 yards in front of me is the RidgeWay. And behind me is the climb. That was a good workout. This high bit of land here is known as Lammy Down. Rumour has it if you go up there and turn round 7 times, the devil shall appear. Oh! Talk of the devil!
Alright.
How are you?
Good. far too much gear.
I see you're dressed in a red top.
Yeah.
Look like a devil, Tony.
Good.
Well, we've met up with Tony, we're just admiring the views as we ride along the Ridgeway. We've got about 6 to 8 miles to go to a campsite, Tone.
Yeah, something like that. Not totally sure, but it's less than 10.
We'll know when we get there. Well, you see, before me on the left there, the ramparts of Effington Hill Fort. We're climbing up in a low gear on the Ridgeway. Been on the road now for about an hour, and we've probably only met 3 people. So I can deal with that sort of traffic. Can you, Tone?
Yeah.
This is drinking water fountain. It's a memorial tap. And we're up near Sparsholt now. This is the last water you'll get from here to the Thames. I think it's running. Sometimes it's not running. Yeah, we're running. Low pressure water.
Peter
Wren. We are Peter Wren, that's it. It's a memorial to poor little Peter. Peter Wren. Who died at age 14. His parents placed this tap here in memory of Peter Wren. Peter Wren. Thanks, Peter. Not a bad place for a memorial. We're losing the light now, but this area here, this is known as the Devil's Punchbowl, all this. And it's a beautiful area, but we're heading down along the Ridgeway and going to camp in the next half a mile, I think. We have to anyway, because we're losing the light, as you can see. Well, unless we can find somewhere better, we're going to be camping in this field. The wind's coming into us, which is a bit unfortunate, but it's not as though it's blowing a gale, it's just a sort of steady breeze, really. Nice soft turf though. Here's my new get me started in the morning breakfast cereal, McVitie's digestive chocolate biscuits and a cup of coffee. Not a bad way to start a day. Thank you. sun just coming up. Look at that. What a wonderful view. All the way down. And down into the Devil's Punchbowl. Just packed the tent down. Tony's getting his tent packed down now. And then we'll soon be on our way. Well, that's it, Tone. This will be the end of the video now. Have you enjoyed yourself?
Yeah. And, always enjoy a night out in the wild camping.
Yeah, a good one. Right. Thanks for the company.
It's good. Thanks
for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.
See ya.